Taxi. I have the privilege of welcoming our speaker this morning. Good. Good job. Okay. Many of you have seen him around campus. He is a senior here at M Christian. Very, very well-rounded young man. 4.0 GPA, cross country, basketball. You see him on the basketball court very soon. Runs track. He went to Boys Nation in Washington, D.C. He even met the President of the United States of America. He had a talk with him. He can even do a backflip. I've seen it with my own eyes. So let's give a warm and Christian welcome to Marcus Waterman. Texas, Ohio, very cool, very cool. I stayed in the state, but I had a good time. You guys like pie? Did you get a lot of pie on Thanksgiving? No, yes. I don't know if that's a thing anymore, but what's your favorite type of pie? I just want to know. I want to take a poll. Raise your hand. Somebody, okay, what's your favorite? Okay, we got apple. Raise your hand if you like apple, the very most. No. No, okay. Okay, what about you? What do you like?
Cherry.
Ah, there you go. He knows what's up. All right, we're gonna take a poll. We got cherry right now. I want to get one more that everybody likes. You guys like pumpkin pie? Yeah. Okay. Okay, we got cherry. We got pumpkin. If you like cherry more, raise your hand. Oh my gosh. You guys have a lot to learn. Okay, if you like pumpkin pie more, raise your hand. All right. So pumpkin pie wins. All right. Very cool, very cool. Well, I want to tell you a little about myself. I'm going to tell you about myself. Coach, or your principal, Mr. Dwell, already told you a little bit, but I'm a sportsy guy. I love sports. Played sports all my life. Grew up playing basketball. Played football when I was a little kid. We have any football players? Yeah. Come on. Okay, what about basketball players? Yes, there you go. I like you guys. All right, very cool. Well, anyway, I played basketball since I was big enough to dribble a ball, and I play to this day. If you come to some of the basketball games, you'll see me out there, but love basketball. I love the outdoors, growing up outside, basically. Oh, yeah, this guy knows what's up. I love the outdoors, spend a lot of time outside, but I also like school. No, okay, hold on. I like some parts of school, I dislike other parts of school. I like school because I get to see my friends. I like school because it gives me opportunities like going to Washington, D.C. for free and meeting the president, which is pretty cool. It's just pretty cool, whether you like him or not. It's still pretty cool. Anyway, I'm kind of happy to be back to school. It's fun to see everybody, but I want to talk to you guys about ways that we can apply our faith, our Christianity, right? Because we claim to love the Lord, we claim to want to do what Jesus told us to do and follow what the Bible says, but it's kind of hard to find specific ways to apply it daily, right? Because we hear, love God, love Jesus, follow the Bible, but how do we do that? Right? You guys are in middle school, how do you do that on a day-to-day basis? So that's kind of what I want to talk about. And I want to ask, do you guys know what the two greatest commandments are? Anybody? Raise your hand. Alright, you got one of them. You got the first one. Love your neighbor as yourself. There you go. And love God. So, the Lord says that the two greatest commandments, the ones that all of the other laws fall under, are to love God and love your neighbor. And I want to read a verse for you. You guys have probably heard it before, actually. It's in Matthew. And it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all of your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. Right? So we understand what God wants us to do. He wants us to follow these two commandments, these two greatest commandments. But I want to talk about practical ways to do that. And I'm going to start off with the first way, which is investing in other people. Which just means that instead of simply concentrating on yourself and thinking about what you need and what you have and what you want, you extend your effort and your energy to try and help other people. And one way to do this, for instance, is if you come into the cafeteria, what do? You probably go sit at the table with your friends, which is cool. That's what I do pretty much every day. But sometimes it's good to look around and notice who doesn't have anybody to sit with. It's good to find the kid who doesn't necessarily have the friends that he sits with every day to go maybe ask him, you want to come sit with us? Or go sit by him, give him a friend. And I'm telling you, I've done it before, and there's no greater feeling than knowing that you're being a friend to somebody who doesn't have one. There's no greater feeling than knowing that you're impacting somebody's life, right? That they're feeling lonely, and you come and you extend a hand to them, and you're friendly to them. That means everything to them. And it's such a little gesture by you. It takes so little effort. So I would encourage you, next time you come to the lunch, look around and notice somebody who maybe doesn't have somebody to sit with. And go talk to them. Go ask them questions. And that's the second part of this, is ask them questions about themselves. Because everybody likes talking about themselves. I like talking about myself, as you guys have probably noticed. But you like talking about yourselves. You like it when people ask you, what are you doing? You know, what do you want to do when you grow up? Different things, what sports do you play? Because that's just a natural human tendency, is we like talking about ourselves. So one of the best ways to make somebody feel at home and feel comfortable with you is to ask them a question about themselves. You know, ask them, what sports are you going to play this year? This kind of thing, because it makes them feel welcome. It makes them feel like somebody cares about them, which they do. They just need to feel that. They need you to come to them with open arms and accepting them when somebody else might not. So I would encourage you to do that and think about that when you come to the cafeteria next time. The next thing I want to talk about is being unmoved, okay? So there's a lot of pressure from other people and just from society as a whole when you graduate and go out into the real world. But even just in a middle school, there's a lot of pressure from other people to do the cool thing, say the cool thing, to not look dumb, to not say something that makes you vulnerable, right? So what I'm challenging you to do and what the Bible challenges us to do is be firm, be bold. Don't worry so much about what other people think. Honestly, I don't really care what other people think. I don't care if one of you thinks I look dumb up here. I don't care. And I think the Lord wants us to go out unmoved, to not worry about what other people think, because God doesn't care what other people think of us, right? As long as we're doing what He asks us to do, then we're doing the right thing. Then He smiles, right? So, if you follow the two greatest commandments, don't change what you do because you're worried about what other people are going to think. Just do the right thing, do what you know is right, and God's going to smile. The second part of this is that if you change what you say or what you think based on what other people say to you, you're going to regret it, I can promise you this. I've done it many times. I've said something that I didn't really believe in, or I've said something just because that was kind of the accepted thing, right? But you're going to regret it, I can promise you that. And what feels better than anything is saying the truth, saying something you know is the truth because you believe it in front of somebody who thinks you're dumb or in front of somebody who is going to criticize you for it and knowing that you stood up for what you actually thought, that you weren't moved simply by what other people thought of you. And I think it's so important, especially where you guys are at right now, because there is so much pressure, especially in middle school, to do the cool thing, to say the cool thing, whatever. My challenge to you guys is just to remember to be unmoved. Don't worry about what people are thinking, because God doesn't worry about that, right? Just follow His two greatest commandments, and He's going to smile. Third thing I want to talk about is resisting temptation. And this kind of goes along with what I talked about just a minute ago, which is resisting doing something simply because of the other people want you to do it, because other people think that's the cool thing. Because it's easy to, it's easy to put somebody else down to make yourself look good. It's really, really easy to do. I've done it before, and I regret it. Right? But what the hard thing is putting somebody else up when it doesn't necessarily make you look good. That's the hard thing to do, but that's the right thing to do. Right? And think about the satisfaction that you'll have knowing that you are applying what God asks us to do. You are applying the Bible to your own life. Even though it seems little, you're applying it to your life. And that's awesome because we never know when we're gonna die, right? Okay, I'm gonna tell you a little bit of a story about this. And it was last January, a little bit over a year ago. And my cousin, who I've grown up with all of my life, who I remember spending time with since I was a little kid, he passed away due to an unexpected problem with his brain. And it wasn't something that he did. He didn't get into an accident. You know, he didn't get into a car wreck or anything like that. It just happened. It was just the way that life went. Is his life ended at a young age when he was 23. So it was hard to process for me, but it makes me realize that I don't know how long my life's gonna be. I don't know whether I'm gonna die before I'm 23 or when I'm 23 at all. I have no idea. But you better know I'm gonna be ready for it. If I die in 10 minutes, I wanna be ready for it, because if I die, I'm standing in front of God. Isn't that a crazy thought? The God who created everything, who knows everything, who knows everything about you, you're gonna be standing in front of him and he's gonna judge you for how you've lived. And my encouragement to you is, invest in other people. You know, make that effort to go talk to somebody who doesn't have a friend or doesn't have somebody to talk to. Go sit by them. It seems little to you, but I promise you it'll have a huge effect on their life. And what I want you to do right now is just bow your head, close your eyes, and think about somebody that you can help this week. Think about something little you can do, somebody who doesn't typically have somebody to sit with, somebody who doesn't have somebody who's interested in them, and ask them the questions. Think of that person right now. And resolve in your own mind that you're gonna do something about it this week. Focus on that person. All right, you can open your eyes. So don't let it slip by. You have the opportunity to make a difference in somebody's life this week. And even though it seems small, God's gonna smile. Because he knows it's a matter of your heart. It's where your heart's at. It's where your intentions are. And if you intend to invest in other people, you intend to help others, God's going to love that. Because that's what he asks us to do. And it's so, so easy. So, invest in other people. And be unmoved. How do we apply that practically, right? Well, we don't worry about what other people think, and that actually goes along with investing in other people. It's not the cool thing to go to a table that has nobody sitting at it except one person who doesn't have friends, right? That's not the cool thing to do. Your friends are going to look at you, you know, funny, and they're going to give you a look, or they're going to be disapproving of it. But that's the right thing to do. So while you need to invest in other people, you also have to remember, don't be moved. Don't worry about it. Simply go and do what you know is right without changing what you're doing because of what other people think. So that's that second aspect. And again, the third aspect is resist temptation. And I'm telling you, where you guys are at right now, there's a whole flood of temptations coming. You may have older siblings, you may know about it, but there is a flood of temptations coming. It's not gonna get any easier from here. It's only gonna get harder. But the fact that it's gonna get harder means you have more of an opportunity to show God that you really care. Right? You have more of an opportunity to resist temptation. So rather than thinking, man, I'm being tempted by this, I might as well just do it, think, I'm being tempted by this, which gives me the opportunity to show God that I care. It gives me the opportunity to follow his two greatest commands and do what he says. So don't be worried about it when there are temptations that come. Just know it's going to happen. And know that when they do, you have the opportunity to turn them down and follow God in a practical way in your life, no matter how old you are. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for this day and for all the things that you've given us. Thank you that we are so, so fortunate. And please help us to remember to invest in other people. to share some of that fortune that we've been given by you, and to not simply think about ourselves, but rather to worry about others and to try and befriend others who maybe don't have anybody to sit by, even something as simple as that. Help us to stand strong when we worry about what other people think. Help us to be unmoved so we don't alter what we're doing. We don't alter our values based on what other people think. Also, be with us when temptation comes. Help us to remember that really what matters is that we follow those two commands. We follow you and we love others. I would just ask that you be with us for the rest of the day. Be with all these kids as they go to their classes. And help them to remember throughout this next week to apply what they find in the Bible to their lives and to apply the two greatest commandments to their lives. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Real quickly, do you guys want more candy? Yeah! Thanks for listening to me. I hope you guys have a great week.